Okay, hello, it's TK5 here. Today I'm going to be talking about Kotal Kahn, and specifically War God, as a character. Go through a few things, a bit of a breakdown tutorial, if you will, and then after that we'll do probably 5 ranked matches and then call it quits. So let us begin with variationless Kotal against Kung Lao, because it's there are a few things that require a character with fast armor, and Kung Lao is probably the best example for that. So let's start off going through what Kotal as a character has to offer for you. He's got the best mid attacks in the game. He only high attacks which can be neutral crouched. For example, I will put him on duck. Oops, that was not duck. High attacks which are standing one, standing two, standing 3 and standing 4 are all high attacks, so they go over the opponent when they're crouching. That looks really funny, but it's a high. Now if I switch up to mid attacks, one sec, Kotal Kahn has the best mid attacks in the game, in my opinion. He's got a lot of mid attacks and really, really long range mid attacks for such a simple character. The mid attack, the mid normal you should use the most is probably back one. See, as you see right there, because he's neutral crouching, he's getting hit by the mid. Back one is probably the best mid in the game, in my opinion. It's minus two on block, which is completely safe, and you can stagger it. He's got forward one, such a long range move from about this distance, forward one, which goes into two different things, which I will explain in a minute. He's got forward two, which is a launcher, which is also a mid attack, which can lead into really big damage. He's got back three, another mid, which leads into a string, and forward four, this is Sparta kick, as I like to call it. Alright, let's talk about his movement. His walk forward speed is probably one of the best in the game. You don't really need to run that much with Kotal. Very fast walk forward speed. Mediocre dashes. Well, not mediocre, they're pretty good for dashes compared to a lot of other characters. His walk back speed is average, but still pretty good. And his run speed, really fast, in my opinion. He's got an alright jump. You will get anti-aired, but luckily he's got one of the best jumping punches in the game, which hits like really far away, and you generally will win air-to-air trades with it. Now the strings that Kotal has universally that are the most important are as follows. Okay, let me just put Kung Lao onto stand. Now 114 is a, it's not really a launcher, but you can combo it into air grab, which can lead into further juggle opportunities. We'll talk about that string in more detail in a minute. Here's the next string, back 1, 2, 2. Probably the string that you will use the most as a punish. Definitely the best string he has. We'll get into that in a minute as well. Back 1, 4. Very unsafe. It's minus 17. So you will get punished for doing it. By a lot of by every character in the game. So you need to cancel it into a special, which we will get into again in a minute. Forward 1, 2. From the forward 1 normal. Very long range. Hard knockdown. It's not a hard knockdown, sorry. It knocks the opponent further away, and it's completely safe from block, which is a godsend. He's also got forward 1, back 2. Same thing from the forward 1, but is a launcher. And the other string you will use the most is the low starter, which is forward 3, 4. Which can combo into other specials, which we will get into in a minute. Okay. The most important thing about Kotal is that if you look at his frame data for his strings, you will notice that the only plus thing he has is 114, which is plus 1. So, there's a way to make this more plus, which is as follows. When you do 114 air grab, you are plus 4 or 5, one of the two. Pretty sure it's 4. Which doesn't guarantee anything afterwards, but your opponent generally does not want to poke afterwards, because they will get hit by either the back one or another poke into the 114 air grab again. So that tool needs to be used quite a lot, especially because he doesn't have any plus frames that don't require meter. So yeah, 114 air grab, back 122, plus plus plus. Okay. One sec. Now let's go into back 122. Now, we'll get into gaps in a minute. So if you do back 122 into enhanced burning sunstone, plus 15 on block. So your opponent has to hold whatever comes next. If you're quick enough, they can armor through, so be wary of that. Oops. Plus. But the thing that hurts Kotal the most are gaps. Now, gaps are opportunities for where your opponent can armor out and punish you for using them. And Kotal has a lot of gaps. And I mean a lot of gaps. Everything he cancels into a special has a gap. For example, I'll show you. Back 1, 2, 2. Gap. Back 1, 4. Gap. Back 1, 2. Gap. He basically has a lot of gaps. There you go. You might get hit by the burning sunstone if they gap, if they armor through, but it's generally always in the opponent's favor. Now, the only strings that Kotal can cancel into a special safely is 114. But, of course, they can armor afterwards. That does jail. So Kotal's full of gaps, and you need to keep that in mind when you do these special moves. You'll get punished a lot by doing them, and you will probably lose a lot of life if you keep using them. Now, we'll quickly go through his special moves that are across the variations. We won't go through this because we're not covering the other two variations. We're doing War God today, so we might as well cover variation specific, which counts to War God as well. So you've got Blood Offering, which is when your Kotal does 10% to himself, and for 3 hits, let me just get the opponent off block. For 3 hits, Kotal will do more damage. So, 1, 2, 3. See, 3 hits. You'll notice when he does the Blood Sacrifice, the knife on his waist will glow red, and you'll know it's the buff is active. You've got God Ray, which heals Kotal and damages your opponent. Pretty self-explanatory. EX version does a bit more to the opponent and heals more to yourself. The air grab is basically exactly how it says. An air grab, so if they jump, you throw them onto the ground. Pretty self-explanatory. You have to be a bit close for it, and the EX version could go into combos. Okay, that's pretty much it for Kotal as a character. War Gods is what we're doing. Yes. Okay. Kotal gains no new strings in this variation. He gains quite a few special moves, which I will go over. Okay, let's start with the 50-50s. He's got down back 1, down back square or X, whatever system you're on, which is an overhead, 9% overhead. Has pretty long range. The EX version launches into a full combo. He's got the low, which is a low, same thing, same damage, but the EX version does not launch, but does a bit more damage. He's got down forward 1, which is an ender. Oops. You can use that to end your combos, and the EX version just does a bit more damage and has armor. All of his EX moves, apart from the projectile, have armor, so that's good. What's next? Sword Toss. Instead of the Sunstone, Kotal gets this move. Very slow. I would never use the projectile in neutral. The EX version's much faster, does a lot of damage, 17% for a projectile, and is very plus on block. Plus 20 on block. So if you get Kung Lao to block always, 1-1-4, that should guarantee that move. Same thing with this. There you go. And for the last special move he gains is Sword Shake, which is an unblockable move. I don't like this move, I never use it, but you can cancel it by holding up when he does that. There you go. The EX version is an OTG as well. So if they're on the ground and you do that, it'll knock them off and give Kotal a bit of extra damage. Okay. Now the interesting thing about War God is that pretty much every string he does can be cancelled into a low or an overhead. For example, you can do back 1-4, low. So that's back 1/4 is mid low, just by default. So you can mix it up by doing back 1/4 overhead, back 1/4 low, or back 1 overhead. So, Kotal, in this variation, Kotal is a very 50-50 based. But there is a downside to that, which I will get into. So, if you look at the string that goes mid, mid, overhead, you can mix it up by doing mid, mid, low, which will definitely confuse your opponent. If you hit them with that enough times, they might not even they might block low just by default because they're expecting the low sword. So you hit them with the overhead, get a nice chunky bit of damage. That's pretty much war god. You've got to mix up what Kotal has in his universal arsenal. You've got to mix it up with the swords. But there is a downside, which I will show right now. Now, every time Kotal cancels into a sword, there's a gap. Gap, 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 gap. The only strings that Kotal does not have a gap in War God is back 1/2/2 overhead. I'll repeat that, back 1/2/1/2/2 overhead does not have a gap. Neither does 1/1/4 into any special. No gap. Whoops. There is a gap there, but that's just a special move in general. No gap. Well, sometimes it doesn't hit. That's pretty much cool. Standing 4 also doesn't have a gap. Oops. No gap. No gap. My bullshit. Basically, anything off 1/1/4 into special does not have gap or standing 4 into special. And also back 1/2/2 overhead. Alright. Now let's talk about punishers. So if I block one of Kung Lao's spins, the most easiest way to punish would be that back 1/2/2 into the down forward 1. Easy 21%. Very easy for the amount of damage you get. You can spend a bar of meter as well, which is back 1/4 overhead, forward 2, forward 1, back 2, 36% for a punish. And that's one bar of meter. You could do back 1 EX air grab. Oops, did that wrong. Okay, that's weird. ...35% if you want to do that. Back 1/2 air grab or 1/1... You could do 1/1/4 air grab. 40% damage. Easy. Now, if you want to do meterless options... Oops. You've got that one. Forward 1, back 2. 26%, no meter involved. 5 more percent than the That's generally your fastest punishing move. So that's pretty much it for punishes. Easy. Once you practice that combo, you would want to use it all the time, because that amount of damage is really good for how easy it is. Okay. Now we've talked a bit about what War God has to offer, let's talk about what War God's basic game plan is. Well, generally, Kotal as a character, you want to stay in your opponent's face. You want to get in really badly, because he does not have no projectiles, but his projectiles are slow and unreliable to be used as a zoning tool. They're slow, they do a lot of damage, but you will get outzoned by characters such as Hishkuten Predator, Pretty Lady, Leatherface, Quan Chi, and other even Molino and Katana. So you want to be in your opponent's face, which is easier said than done. So if you are getting zoned out full screen, the best thing to do is duck the projectile, throw that, and jump, run in while they are recovering from the projectile. Run in forward 1-2, and then dash in afterwards. So his game plan is to rely on the 50-50s. When the opponent does not have any meter whatsoever, it's a lot easier to do the gaps, because 90% of the cast can't armor through without armor. So you can take a few more risks as War God when your opponent does not have any meter. You can do gimmicks like down 4 into special, low overhead. They're all gimmicks. But they do work most of the time. For a wake-up tool, the best armor move to use is the overhead, but it's very predictable, and if your opponent guesses right on your wake-up, you will eat quite a lot of damage, because it's highly punishable, that move. Let's talk about combos. Most of the time you see War God players doing this, back 1-4, overhead, just, that is, if you're playing against a person who knows what they're doing, they will pretty much block that 99% of the time. So only use this when you're punishing a move that they throw out that is unsafe, and you know you can punish. But that's generally the combo. Basic, 36%. If you have 2 bars of meter, you can extend it, extend it by a bit. Wow. Wow, sorry about that. Jeez, what's going on? Awesome. 43%, 2 bars. But that's generally the whiff punishing tool. So, for example, if I record Kung Lao doing this, they've missed their string, and you can punish their whiff with that. It's safe, and you do get quite a bit of damage from it. Your basic combo for 114 air grab. Easy 40%. Easy. You don't have to use the sword at all. You can... 41%. Oops. 35. That's generally it. That's it for combos. In the corner, let's reset to the corner. If you want to keep them in the corner. Whoops. Or you can do some silly stuff like this. Oh, you get the gist of it. You can pretty much do what you want in the corner, keep them there. Now, in the corner, it's where it gets interesting. It's not just necessarily War God, but if you hit someone while the opponent's in the corner, you can do interesting setups. So, you can safely set up the Sunlight. If I put Kung Lao onto Cyclone on Wake Up, let me just check to see if he's doing that. Yep. Watch this. So it's a punish. I'll repeat it. There you go. You can safely set up the Sunlight. It's pretty much like Aaron Black's Caltrops. Depending on how low they are to the ground, it'll work differently. The higher up, the more chance it'll work. So if they're lower on the ground... Oops. Oops. Oh my god. Okay, I'll get it. Wow. Okay, sorry about this. Oh my god. Okay, that was safe, but only just. Sorry it took so long to do that. You can do interesting things with... You can spend an extra bar. Whoops. Oh my god, sorry about this. Wow, why isn't it working? Watch this. How much damage this throw does? 23%. You can also use the blood sacrifice if you've got... Okay, that's pretty much it. That's pretty much War God. So basically his game plan is to stay in their face, be careful when using his swords in strings other than 114, because they all have a gap, and you will get punished, depending on what character you're fighting. For example, if you're fighting a Sub-Zero, they can slide. Kung Lao, he can spin. Melina can just roll without even using armor. So it really depends on your character. All of his swords are unsafe on block, and the majority of the cast can punish them on block. So be careful with that. So now I'm going to play about 5 or so ranked matches with War God only, and just give you a bit of a practical example of what I'm talking about, or talked about, I should say. If there's any questions, please leave it in the comments, and I will get back to you and answer your questions. Between 3 and 5 ranked matches, I don't think 5 will be... I think 5 might be a bit too much, but 3 should be alright. Just to give you a basic rundown of what the character can do. And hopefully it'll be enough. Enough information for you to succeed with this character. He is probably the best variation of Kotal. I will agree to that. He always has been the best variation.
Beware, creature of
round one. Fight.
Oops, that's punishable. Okay. Pretty straightforward.
Round 2. Fight.
Oops. Okay, that was fairly straightforward. Not to be rude to my opponent, but... Right. Hopefully we can get someone with a bit more... not to be rude, like I said, someone with a bit more skill. Come on.
Faction battle.
Okay, this guy's got a record. Let's go with Dark Lord. Okay. Staying in your opponent's face is absolutely crucial. Okay. Don't know why he didn't continue the combo. Easy 37.
Round 2. Fight.
Wow. I always get hit by that. That's my fault though. I'm surprised you got hit by that. That's just luck. It's kind of fatal because that guy pissed me off.
Kotal Kahn wins. Fatality.
It's a problem with random people. They do the same thing over and over. It always catches me off guard. It's hard to download people, you know what I mean by download, like see what they're doing in ranked matches in a 1v1, one game setting. It's pretty difficult. I think we will go for 5.
Faction battle.
I've got the same guy again. Let's go for all the costumes. Now, Melina is a tough matchup for Kotal, because she can keep you out, and she can punish all your swords without even using a bar of meter. Jumper. Fuck no. I don't know what he was doing.
Round 2, fight!
It's gonna wake up. Jump. Go for the brutal. Oh. Okay, that was pretty straightforward. Two more, I think. Let's hopefully we can get someone better. Not to be rude. Okay, got someone a bit better this time. I don't know if that's not Grandmaster, I don't think, but let's have a look.
Katana.
This is number 4, I think. Katana's difficult, because she can keep me out. The other variations of Kotal do a bit better against her because of the parry. But War God isn't hopeless at all. We'll see.
Round 1, fight!
Ah, that's good. Smart. Okay, that was my mistake. Shouldn't have done that. Okay, that was my bad. Try not to jump against Katana. That first round was very messy, but I managed to pull it back.
Your soul burns. Kotal Kahn wins.
Alright, last one. And then I will sign off. Okay. 0% win odds. I'm gonna guess he's Kenshi. I'm just assuming. Could either be really good for me or really bad. And a level 101. Gotta save that screenshot. Balanced. What? That should not happen. Try to block. What the f- this game drives me. Sometimes it doesn't make any sense whatsoever. But we can try to pull it back.
Round, fight!
can't even nooch closer. Yes, and with fatalities.
Kotal Kahn wins fatality.
Okay, well, thank you for watching. I really appreciate it. This will be on YouTube. Hope you enjoyed, and I shall be streaming again soon.